Yes.
This is it, eh?
Chuck, wait. Go to your right.
Like this?
A little bit to your right.
Yeah, but tell me...
To your right.
Yeah, but why to your right?
Now salute.
Yeah, but...
Perfect for the picture, eh?
But can you see the whole plane?
I can see 20 centimeters on each side.
Is it okay?
Yes.
Like this?
Salute. Perfect.
So I will cut this for thumbnail, and of course, first of all, salute all subscribers and viewers. Thanks for your support, for visiting our channel, for all your comments, for your subscriptions, and for sharing and spreading the passion for the RC planes from this channel to the rest of the world.
Yes, yes.
Of course, thanks also for every thumb up and for sharing the videos on the social media, because by that day, the more and more people will know about our channel, and the more and more people we hope will try.
So the community will grow.
Planes for the first time, eh? Now, enough of talking, I will just tell you this, that of course, this channel, we have dedicated this channel for nothing to edit. We don't edit nothing, what you see is what you get on this channel, we turn the camera on and what the hell. We show you the experience with the planes from the first hand. And of course, we said that we will try to fly and test as many different planes as possible while we're filming. Enough Captain Blush of this, eh?
Yes.
And now let's get to the point, what we have today on the table. Of course, it will be the maiden flight, and for once we have almost no wind. And of course, they say for the next few days we will have rain. So we have with us...
Thunderstorms.
The thunderstorms are coming. I have three planes with me, and I hope that we will film something. But first, of course, we will start with this beautiful and sexy, iconic Second World War plane.
Yes.
The Fisler FI-156. The famous Sturce.
Yes.
No, I think that this can go in the category of the slowest possible flying planes. Check on the internet, on the YouTube, the history of this plane, because if you will check the history of this plane, eh, you will be even more impressed to have the version in the RC. And of course, today we have the Dancing Wings Hobby version, Bulsa, that for now it will run.
Dancing Wing Hobby.
Yeah, models. That in fact for
do
now
we, it do will... you need a back?
Yes. That in fact for now, Captain Blush, it will work on the electro motor, eh?
Yes.
Now I think that initially this plane was meant to be, I mean the details are great, eh? Initially I think that this plane was made for the glow engine on. You can still stuck it on, but we have said, okay, we will try to show you also not just the foam planes, let's start with some Bulsa planes, but let's not exaggerate. For the first time, let's try Bulsa with electro, and later we can stack some glow engine on, eh? 1.6 meter wingspan, that will run on 4 cell. That is the setup, eh? All that you need in one box, you will have the link below. Click it, check it, if you like it, click, don't wait too long, eh? But I will tell you that it has really great features like the original one. Even the bending wings, say. You can even bend the wings to the back like it was on the original one for the transport and to put it in the hangar, eh?
Yes.
And it has one another feature, it has the working slats. Now, I don't know for what is that, because I have checked, in fact, the original plane did have the fixed slats. But I mean, since we have the option here to put it on the servo, and maybe this will be fun to fiddle and see how the plane will fly with them or without them. Of course, it also have the working flaps, the ailerons, rudder, elevator, and that's it.
Yes.
The assembly, Captain Blush, you can say a few words, because well, the plane you have assembled.
Well, the assembly went actually pretty good. There is nothing to not know, because the user's manual is... It's such a precise thing that you know each part where it goes, and it's very easy.
I mean, look at the bottom of this, even this side. I mean, tell me that this is not sexy.
Yes.
All this silver curl, or this wire, say the yellow and everything. I mean, it looks amazing. Okay? I just hope that it will fly as good as it looks.
Yeah, we will soon find out. Eh?
Now, of course, the rest of the assembly was mine, and if you would love to... For this plane to work with all the features on, you will need the 7 channels. Now, I was telling you that this one initially was meant for the glow engine because of one thing, and that is the battery compartment. In fact, in this plane, I can't stack bigger battery than 2200 if I want to get the CG. Of course, show the battery. Even with that battery, I won't get the perfect CG. I had to put a big steel plate in the motor.
Yeah.
On the motor mount, you can see here, look.
Wait.
Check inside here. Maybe you will see above.
No, I can't.
On top of the motor mount, there is a big piece of steel.
Uh-huh.
And with that steel, I have now the CG according to the book. Otherwise, I can't. I was trying to stuck in the 3300 battery, but it just doesn't go in because that hole is just too small to put it in. Eh? So you will have to put a big weight here. On top of the motor, and I will show you, of course,
it's too small.
CG. Yeah, of course it is, Captain.
Or the battery is too big.
And this time I will do one crazy thing. I mean, hey, look at the receiver. Eh? I will use the V3 version of the orange receiver switch. In fact, in the past, I didn't have no problems with them.
Well, the good thing is that you've put one antenna out, eh?
I have realized, I have watched really closely the videos when I thought that I had the problems with this, and every time, do you know where the problem was? Always if the one antenna was somewhere behind the battery. In some positions when you fly, if the antenna will be behind the battery, then I had the signal loss, say. But now since I have the antennas to the back, because our thing is, I'm flying, do you know why? I'm flying that big 2-meter beaver all the time on the orange receiver, and it flies perfect, no brown outs. But I have the receiver up and the antennas way.
There was one brown out, eh?
Yeah, of course it was.
But not on the plane, eh?
Oh, really?
Yes.
Of you?
No, you.
I didn't brown out nothing, Captain Blosch.
At the back, eh?
Yeah, but, eh, what's with you?
The brown out in your pants.
Yeah, but if there was a brown out, right now, brown out, it was yours, not mine.
Yeah, but not now. I'm not talking about now.
Yeah, but when?
Yeah, one time, I don't know.
Yeah, one time. I have brown outs many times, but not now on the camera, Captain Blosch. What's with you?
And I didn't say now.
And of course, I will show you this. Since I can't secure the battery good inside here, how can you do this, eh? I will secure it with this, eh?
Ah.
This piece of wood, and I hope it will work, eh? Enough of
babbling,
because this will be...
You're just postponing again, eh?
You can see here now, if I take out, I can now take out the ESC, I can't even fix it inside. Because otherwise you won't be able to...
To put the battery in.
How can you put the battery in? How can you plug it? I can plug it like this. And now I can put the battery in.
Yeah.
Like this, you will see. Even this is not so easy. And look. Where is it stuck right now at this moment? Eh?
Take your time. Maybe behind the cable?
Oh, I don't know where is it this time. It can't be. What's in here? Because usually this is the one thing that what's this? Why? Hey,
let me check.
It was going inside every time.
Is there any cable?
It's not.
Is it? Yeah.
Like this? Yeah, I hope still. Wait.
What?
Okay. I was thinking that maybe I can disconnect some cable.
No, it's okay.
You must be careful. And now I will put this. Look. You will come here later and I will show you. Because it's just like this. And now I push it in. And that's it, eh?
Let me show the viewers.
Check. This is how I can secure the battery good. And it must be...
So you're also...
Yeah.
You're also a woodworker, eh?
The battery is now all the way to the front. And like this, I will show you. I have something...
That is called the CG.
Yeah. Then I can call a CG. Look.
Yes.
I will show it just so later we won't have any
issues.
Strange comments. Look.
Oh, perfect, eh?
Look at this.
Hey.
A little nose heavy, and just like it should be.
And that's it.
Yeah, of course.
And now let's just hope for some good maiden, eh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Really hope, eh?
Yeah, we will see.
Yeah, Rods!
right, left, up, down, left, right, the throttle,
yeah,
like this, of course, the flaps.
Yes.
I have mixed them a little
With the elevator.
With the down elevator.
And now the slats.
And now the slats, look at this. This is the most sexy thing. Look at this, eh?
Yes.
Now I have seen on one store, Che, I think that Maxford or something, some company that makes this.
Maxford USA?
Yeah. They have the slots connected on the same servo with the elevator, with the flaps. So when you put the flaps, the slats come down, but the slats should be here all the time, eh? I don't think that you will fly this, some acro flight, inverted and rolls and I don't know what. The plane wasn't meant for that. I mean, hey, if that turns you on, you can do with your Storch whatever you want, but I will just fly, I will try to fly this plane slow and sexy.
Normal fashion way.
Slow and sexy, and that was the point of this plane. They were flying as slow as possible, eh? But Captain Blush, I think that it would be good to do the range check this time, huh? I will do the range check quick.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, just so we won't be sorry later. It doesn't take much time. I will just put the range check 30 paces and that's it.
Chuck, wait, I must grab the plane.
Grab the plane.
Where will you go? On which side?
I will just go there directly from the plane. Are you ready?
Wait.
Reduced power.
Yes.
Are you ready?
Yes, now you can do it.
I have now reduced power and let's start to count. Aha, I will go from here, 30 paces.
What? Did you pull the flaps?
No.
You must not turn the back. Nah. You must walk like this.
Like this?
Whenever you turn the back, there is an obstacle between the antenna. Like this, yes.
Of course, it's an obstacle.
Yeah.
You must go backwards or what?
Yes, the antenna must be recast, ne?
Yeah, of course.
Kusa babana shakol, op, flaps.
Oh, you should test it now?
Yeah. Okay.
The ailerons?
Perfect. Yes.
Grab it.
I'm grabbing it, yes.
Bottle.
Perfect. This is 30.
Okay,
This is 230 Kurako.
Yeah.
Okay.
It should be okay.
That's it. Come back. You must never turn your back.
Of course, you are never turned away from the.
No.
You never fly turned away from the plane.
Now, without further ado, hey, I think it's about time.
Should I taxi or just?
No. You just put it on the table and that
with some. Have two big holes.
Yeah, there are two big holes here now.
I have set this to 5 minutes.
Now good luck.
Throttle cut on just in case.
Yes.
And I think that I will. I don't know. Should I fly with slats or what?
Take off. No. You take off normally and then you try slats in the air.
Yeah, but hey, the original plane had slats all the time.
Yes, but you don't know this plane now, eh?
Yeah, but I think that it will fly even better with the slats.
Hey,
not?
Salute Tomislav Grgetic, eh? Do you know why?
Because he has a plane like
this. He has a plane like this with the laser V-twin engine, eh?
Do they put some flaps? Nothing. I will go like this.
Nah, I go like this.
I will go in the high rates.
Well, the rain is coming from.
That's it. We made the flight with Dancing Wings Hobby Storche. Yeah, that's it, eh?
That's it.
Now or never.
So help you God.
I really wonder about the slats, eh?
I don't know.
It would be great that we have them fixed, so then we wouldn't wonder
what
to do with them, eh? Okay, I will go without them and let's
do you know what I think? That the slats will push your plane down.
No, the slats are meant so you can really fly slow.
Uh-huh.
Enough?
Enough. I like that voice. Whenever I hear, oh yeah, I know it's a good thing, eh?
Yeah, but I must...
Trim?
Trim it really good, eh?
Yeah, but you will do it.
I must see quick.
Does it want to go to the right? Perfect.
Pretty sexy, huh?
Yes.
I will come once more back. I will see once more. I will see now what to trim. I will leave it a little up. More to the left.
Look at those clouds, eh?
Hey, and now we have the plane, eh? Low and sexy, Captain Blush. You see it, boat?
Yes. Looks like I have assembled this pretty good, eh?
This flies perfect, eh? Look at this, eh? Three minutes. Now I will go a little up.
Yes.
I won't put the sleds too close to the ground. I will just see what will happen. I will put them now. Aha. Oh.
Yeah.
No good, eh?
Huh?
No good.
Are they turning the plane?
Oh, they have pushed the plane down, really, like you said.
No.
Eh? I think that we know what.
What?
It says in the manual you have to set them, eh? Just the correct way. So maybe I should put them on the slider, huh?
Yes, so you can slide them very slowly so you know what the plane is doing.
The position, because at this point I have too much. But I will try the flaps now. Let's see the flaps. These are now the
flaps.
I have now the
landing flaps.
Takeoff flaps, landing flaps, yeah. Did you saw that?
Yes.
You know what that was?
What?
Pretty close to stall. And you know what I have also realized? I have the mixing here. I have the mixing with the
elevator,
down elevator, and it doesn't need it. It wanted to push down the plane. So now I know two things. I will just fly it like it is. You see it good?
Yes, prepare. You must not forget.
Oh, I can see the rain.
Yes, this is why I told you.
One more low from the other side. And then I will land. I can hear the raindrops.
Yes, the raindrops. Oh! One just came to my head, eh?
Do you see it good?
Uh-huh.
The last flyby and now the landing. Wish me good luck.
Can you hear the raindrops on the plane?
I can hear. Wait. Hush.
Now get quick to the plane and we will go under the roof. Give me the transmitter.
This was unbelievable. Take it quickly.
Hey, look. Hey, the rain has... Hey, but what's this, eh?
This is unbelievable, eh?
Well, at least you have done a really good maiden flight, eh?
We're just in time, eh?
I'm under the roof. Look at this. The rain is... Let me show you the rain.
So great. Because I can hear the rain.
Yeah, we can see the raindrops falling, eh, because of your black dress. Not dress,
because
t-shirt.
If you have the foam plane, then you don't hear the drops, eh?
Now let's go here.
Bring it to you. Listen to this. Listen to this. This is the first time.
Oh.
This is the first time that we can hear. Listen. Raindrops on the plane.
Yeah, but I have open windows on my car.
Who cares? Listen to this.
Yeah, who cares about my car? Yeah.
Close your windows and I will go there. Close your windows in the meanwhile, Captain Blush.
Camera back.
Close the windows.
Yes, I will close my windows really quickly with my remote control. Quick. Close. Yes, like this. Perfect.
Hey,
this will be the perfect maiden flight, eh?
When have we...
Yeah, my phone, eh?
When have we run away...
Give me my phone. It's all
when
wet.
When have we run away from the runway because of...
The rain?
Yeah, Chuck, wait. I must... We must...
Unplug the battery?
Yeah.
Chuck, let me... I cannot hold it for
this.
Yeah, Chuck, I will. Okay, do it now.
And do you know what, eh?
Oh, no. Yeah.
One
do it
thing,
like this.
One thing, my friend, say.
What?
Do you see?
Uh-huh, the orange.
That, in fact...
Was it perfect?
Like I have said, there wasn't a single glitch, I didn't have a single glitch, and finally now I know why I was flying without the problems in the past, but lately, but not lately, then a few times I did have a problem, but like I have said, I have analyzed the videos and I have discovered that in fact every time there was a problem was because I had one antenna behind
the battery.
Behind the battery.
Yes.
I will turn off.
You're just too big to be under this hood, eh?
Well, it's okay.
Like this?
Wait, Captain Blush.
Can you put the plane in the car?
No. I will do something, look.
So you can stand in the rain, eh?
Yeah, you will stand there.
Under
umbrella.
Yes. Under my umbrella, Ella.
It will be easier for me.
Yeah, like this, yes.
Yeah. I mean, this is what kind of a closure of the window, I mean. My friends, this is epic, eh?
Yeah, but this proves that nothing can stop us, eh?
What can stop us, eh? I mean, the rain did shorten the window, but hey, look at this.
So wait, leave it like this. I'm zooming. 38%, this is it, eh?
38%, and I wasn't even... was I a little over or maybe not?
Nah, 30 seconds, uncle.
So that means that with this battery for the next time, in case I will try to fly it more fast...
Yeah.
I will put it to 4 minutes, Captain Blush.
And do it, I will do it right away?
Right away, because later
so you don't forget. Just don't forget that you have a plane in between your legs, eh? Don't step on it.
I was flying for 4 minutes and 30 seconds and this was the storage, so I will go the timer. I will go back to 4 minutes just in case, and later I will work from there.
Yes.
Like this. And like this, okay.
So
I can grab it now in my hands.
Yes.
The beautiful and sexy Storche. I mean, this is unbelievable.
Yeah, no, it's not over yet, but soon.
But maybe it will stop, eh? Now what to tell about the experience after this flight? Well, hey, the plane with the little rudder, eh? It behaves perfect in the air, eh? The what I have discovered about the sleds, the way I have them now, check at the beginning, that was at least, they were at least one too big, the travel. The next time I will put them, maybe I will have here, at the back here, maybe I will have this gap, I don't know.
Yes, okay.
3 millimeters, not more. Because now I think that I have around 6 millimeters of the gap when I put them forward. And when I have put the sleds, the plane really just went, it was sucked down really bad. I mean, that didn't help nothing on this plane. So next time I will put it just a little. I will work from, I don't know, maybe from 2 millimeters.
Yeah.
and Murray. But I will set them on the knob. I won't guess with the slider, because if you will put them too much, you will crash the plane. The second thing that I have discovered, the flaps work perfect, but you don't need no down trimming on the elevator. Mm-hmm. No trimming, just leave them like they are, because I had to push up elevator all the time, and you have seen that I have almost stalled the plane because of that. That is nothing. Put the flaps without any mixing and they will work great. But otherwise, I'm really impressed. But I will tell you this, that in fact, this CG was...
What? Perfect?
Was great, eh?
I know.
Maybe I could have put a little... I will tell you, I have put the steel, the flat steel, 5 millimeters by 30. It was exactly 75 millimeters long. That was the weight on this plane.
Yeah, but what is the thickness of the...
5 millimeters by 30. The flat steel...
Flaheisen.
30 millimeters by 5, 75 millimeters long. Next time I would put it as 10 millimeters less.
Uh-huh.
6.5, and it will give you the perfect CG, and of course with 2200 battery all the way to the motor, to the front. And you have seen the solution how to stick inside just the wooden stick, and it will grab your battery without any problems, and you will be one happy pilot after the flight, eh?
Yes.
So this is it, eh?
No, it's still raining.
The rain has stopped. Okay, you can be under umbrella, because I love to grab the plane like this. The assessment at the end, for the scaliness of the looks and everything, I will give it 9.5, eh? Mm-hmm. But for flying characteristic, I will give it 8.5 at this point. So altogether this plane I will give 9 at this point, because at this point I still don't know how the slats should work, because for me they weren't working. Now I should put them a little less, and of course this mixing with the down elevator didn't work, eh? But that is just for the flight experience. Otherwise the plane was flying really great, and I believe that if you will click on this, you will have one sexy plane. But don't go with the bigger battery or something, I don't know what. Otherwise you will have you will have too heavy plane for the size and for the wideness of the wings, eh? But otherwise, I just wish that today it was the sunny day, so we would see the plane better. But I think that Captain Blush, we have seen something, huh?
Of course, eh?
Okay, so this is it.
You've seen a very sexy maiden flight.
This is it, eh? I can't wait for the second test, eh? When I will know more how to really, really fly this plane slow, eh? So this is it, eh?
Yes.
Pilot Robert and Captain Blush signing off from Slovenia with beautiful maiden flight of the Dancing Wings Hobby Fissler Storch 1.6 meter that runs on 4-cell batteries. And of course, maybe you can just forget about that. You can just buy yourself this plane without the motor, and you can just stuck inside here a beautiful and sexy glow 4-stroke Saito engine, eh?
Yes.
If you are a lover. But like I have said, the great thing is that this baby is now an option to click on the internet in the BitGo Hobby Store or Dancing Wings Hobby. You have the links below, so check. So that's it. Good enough?
Yes.
Captain Blush, get quick! Because I don't know.
This is it.
I mean, that this is it for today. We have 2 more planes, but we won't feel nothing because the wind has started. But I will sleep good because of this great maiden flight, eh?
Yes.
Viewers, we love you all. Expect more pretty soon, eh? Don't let something like the rain and the wind bother you, eh? You can have fun because you never know what will happen tomorrow. Even if you have to land sooner than you have thought, eh, at least you were in the air, because who knows if you will have the option tomorrow to go and to fly something. So this is it, eh?
Yes.
Thanks again, eh?